Giovanni.
My name is Christina Scheppelman. I'm the general director of Seattle Opera.
I'm Doug Provost. I'm the director of production for Seattle Opera.
The decisions around Don Giovanni, of course, are very much based on the overall situation with COVID, on health and safety protocols. And it was part of our season. It was planned for our season. And obviously what we are doing at the end, or what we're doing right now, is different than we'd planned originally, because we're not on stage, we're not in the house with an audience that gives you the energy of an audience. But there is a great energy among the cast, because it is so different. That in itself is the exciting part.
What's really fascinating has been watching the switch be flipped in people's minds about how to produce opera when we're doing it for a video capture. So really getting people to start to think, okay, well, now we don't have to fill the entire space. What we're really focusing on is filling the viewfinder. We have a multi-viewer so that we can see each camera shot and it shows up on the screen. And so now instead of watching the action on the stage, we're now watching the action in the viewfinder. The soundtrack was a particularly interesting journey because we have converted our Tagney Jones Hall to be our recording studio. We have created a social distancing schematic. Each performer is spaced out. We have the maestro and the piano player all recording live. We're going to take that content, and when it's time for us to do the live video sequences, we will play back their soundtrack, so they'll sing along, but they won't be singing full out, so that their mouth movement matches what they sang a few days earlier.
Obviously, for operating here and for producing here, we need to operate under strict health and safety protocols that have been discussed and worked out with the unions, with the Department of Health, and we've worked very hard to come up with a protocol that protects everybody. I mean, safety is incredibly important. We all want to be safe as much as we all want to work and produce and be creative. But paramount is really the health and safety of everybody involved.
We always keep the social distance, so 6 feet, wash your hands, those are pretty common. Some things that are not so common is AGMA, the Singers Union, has said that we provide enough space so that we have 5 feet behind the performer and 15 feet in front of the performer so that as they sing, their aerosols have a place to travel and not interact with a human being. And so what we did, working with the stage director long before we started staging, is we started to do various arrangements to make sure that the cast would be safe as they were to do their staging. And so we took painter's tape and we kind of created a grid on the floor so that they could kind of visually see, okay, one line, 6 feet, 12 feet, and so forth. And we did the paint treatment on the floor to be able to replicate that so that the performers can always make sure that they're, you know, at a safe distance from one another.
It's been really great to work with our maestro and stage director. Lidia Jankowskaja, our maestro, and Brenna Korner, our stage director, have been incredible collaborators in this process, because obviously when they originally set out to do this Don Giovanni, it was under completely different circumstances. And as we got closer to the actual production, we had to adjust and make certain cuts and rethink many elements of this Don Giovanni, and they've been great. Everybody has been dedicated and really focused on every detail, and it's been, I dare to say, it's been fun. So with all that said, I can only now say, please come and watch it, go and enjoy the stream, enjoy this Don Giovanni. It's great music, it's great drama, and I think it's a really special Don Giovanni that you get to see. So have fun and come and join us.